the innovation developed by Chemistry Department Chairman Professor David Ryan and a group of UMass Lowell students will enable electric vehicles of all sizes to run longer while maintaining zero emissions. The new technology uses water, carbon dioxide, and the metal cobalt to produce hydrogen gas on demand at a relatively low temperature and pressure. Most electronic vehicles on the road today rely on batteries that must be charged, but come with limitations such as storage capacity, time needed to recharge, and of course cost, according to Ryan. As a result, current technology is practical only for small cars and not for larger vehicles. That includes trucks and buses. In contrast, the UMass Lowell team's invention could be used to power vehicles of all sizes. In an electric vehicle, the hydrogen created by the team's method would go directly to a fuel cell where it would mix with oxygen from the atmosphere to generate electricity and, of course, its byproduct, water. The electricity would then power the system that operates the vehicle's motor, rechargeable battery, and headlights. This process doesn't store any hydrogen gas, so it's safe and poses no transportation issues, greatly minimizing the possibility of a fire or an explosion. The technology generates hydrogen, which is more than 95% pure. Hydrogen burns completely clean. It produces no carbon dioxide and only water. And you don't have to burn hydrogen to generate electricity. Hydrogen can be used in fuel cells in which it combines with oxygen from the air to produce electricity at up to 85% efficiency. With increasing demand for green energy, the hydrogen market is poised to grow to an estimated $199 billion over the next 4 years, according to industry experts. The researchers have been awarded a provisional patent and are awaiting a full patent on the technology. In addition to support from UMass Lowell, the Massachusetts Clean Energy Center has provided the team with a $25,000 seed funding round to help take the invention from the lab into the marketplace. Angry Birds is taking the battle to another dimension. Ours. The popular franchise's next mobile game, Angry Birds Isle of Pigs, will harness augmented reality to let players knock down pig-filled fortresses animated over your everyday world. If this sounds familiar, it's because a version of this game had been announced in fall 2018 as Angry Birds first-person slingshot for the Magic Leap. There's even a VR version of Isle of Pigs that launched in February for the Vive and Oculus Rift, but we did say mobile. You'll be able to play this new edition of Isle of Pigs on most iOS devices as a free-to-play game. TechRadar got an early look at the title in the weeks leading up to GDC 2019. Rovio Entertainment, the studio behind the Angry Birds franchise, gave a live demonstration of Isle of Pigs, which was developed by Resolution Games, as were the earlier Magic Leap and VR versions. TechRadar saw how it will play on a smartphone, and the answer is surprisingly well. Angry Birds Isle of Pigs has the same basic goals as the puzzle games in the franchise. Toss different kinds of birds into elaborate forts populated by villainous pigs and see if you can knock it all down. As players progress, fortifications become more elaborate, requiring precision and novel tactics to topple targets and win the day. And finally, happening in this week's What The, when CNN attempted to reach Chris Ferry, his voicemail was full. The New Jersey man's phone has been inundated with texts and calls from well-wishers ever since his sons bought him a billboard near Atlantic City. The sign reads, "Wish my dad a happy birthday," and includes Ferry's photo and phone number. The billboard went on March 6th, and Ferry has already received more than 15,000 messages from all over the world wishing him a happy 62nd birthday, even though the actual day isn't until March 16th. Ferry's two sons, Michael and Chris, were stumped on what to get their dad for his birthday this year. When they were young, they used to tell waiters at restaurants that it was their dad's birthday to pull his leg and maybe get a free dessert out of the deal. the younger Chris Ferry said. So they decided to continue to honor his dad in a funny way. The younger Chris Ferry had recently purchased a billboard outside Atlantic City for his addiction recovery center, and he became inspired to get one for his dad as well. I called my brother Michael and said, what if we put dad's picture right on the billboard and say, wish him a happy birthday? The prankster in me came out, Chris Ferry said. My brother said he loved it. He was dying laughing. He added, it's go big or go home. Thanks for watching your weekly tech update. If you have a story you think we should feature on the program, you need to shoot me an email, djraymcneil@gmail.com. Find us on Facebook at Your Weekly Tech Update and check out the podcast, audio and video versions available on iTunes, Google, Spotify, Audio Burst, and elsewhere on the interwebs. Till next time, I'm Ray McNeil. Good night, world. Your weekly tech update brought to you by Holiday Home Care, Phillip Island, Victoria, Australia. It's your turn to relax.